Hey Frozen community! Today we're unboxing and installing the Penta Shield, a new accessory designed by Frozen for the ARCO printer. Now let's get started. Once you've received the product and removed the outer packaging, you'll find these components inside the box. These parts will help us successfully install the Penta Shield onto the machine. First on the touchscreen, tap Tools, then Manual Adjustment, and move the extruder to a position about 20 centimeters above the PEI plate. Next, turn off the power and unplug the power cable. After that, use a 3mm hex wrench, loosen the screws on the filament spool bracket, and remove it. Next, remove the retaining clip on the extruder. Press down the PTFE clamp and pull out the PTFE tube. Then, locate the tube guide on the top of the machine, press down the PTFE clamp, and remove the PTFE tubes on both sides of the tube guide. Next, remove the top cover of the tube guide and the tube guide itself. Then use a 2.5mm hex wrench to remove the tube guide seat. If the machine has a chroma kit installed, take a 2mm hex wrench, loosen the M3x16 screws on the four-way cable organizer, and remove the organizer from the extruder. Then remove the chroma kit and the left and right support brackets from the machine in sequence. Finally, remove the corner plastic protective covers on the machine's columns. Take a 2.5mm hex wrench, loosen the two M3x5 screws on the inner side of the column, and remove the cover. Repeat the same steps to remove the covers from all four columns. Once that's done, we can start installing the Penta Shield components. Before we begin, here's an important reminder. When installing the Penta Shield, it's recommended to have two people work together to ensure the process is smoother and safer. First, on the inner side of the front right column, locate the two holes at the top and bottom. Take out the magnets and align them with the holes. Must make sure the side with the magnet must face toward the inside of the machine. Once aligned, we're ready to insert the screws. Here's a tip. When securing parts with screws, always pre-tighten them first to hold the components in place. After confirming all screws are properly aligned, tighten them fully. This prevents misalignment or cross-threading. Take the M3x4 screws and use a 2mm hex wrench to pre-tighten the screws to secure the magnets. After both the top and bottom screws are pre-tightened, fully tighten them. Next, we'll install the back panel. Take a 2mm hex wrench and remove the two M3x8 self-tapping screws from the back of the machine. Set them aside for later use. Now, take the back panel and align its holes with the holes on the back of the machine. A quick reminder, in addition to aligning the holes, make sure the fan on the back panel faces outward. Once aligned, have one person hold the panel in place while the other uses a 2mm hex wrench to pre-tighten two M3x4 screws into the top two holes to secure the panel. Then, take six more M3x4 screws and pre-tighten them in a diagonal sequence in the middle positions. Finally, take the two M3x8 self-tapping screws you set aside earlier and pre-tighten them into the bottom two holes. After confirming all screws are in position, tighten the eight M3x4 screws in a diagonal sequence. Then fully tighten the two M3x8 self-tapping screws at the bottom. Once the panel is secured, locate the NTC signal connector and fan power connector inside the machine's groove. Remove the dust caps from the connectors and connect the back panel's NTC signal cable and fan power cable. After connecting, neatly route the cables into the lower groove. Next, we'll install the side windows. Take out the side window and remove the protective film. Align the side window with the holes on the side of the machine. Make sure the ARCO logo on the side window faces outward and toward the back panel. Once aligned, have one person hold the side window while the other uses a 2mm hex wrench to pre-tighten four M3x10 screws from the outside in, starting with the upper holes on the outer side. Then, take three M3x4 screws and pre-tighten them from the outside on the lower inner side of the fixing plate. After confirming all screws are aligned and inserted, tighten them in the same order. Repeat the same steps to install the side window on the other side. Once both side windows are installed, we'll move on to the top cover. Take out the support rods and align the holes on the mounting plates with the holes on the top beam of the machine. A quick reminder, the flat side of the mounting plate should be flush with the outer side of the beam. Once aligned, have one person hold the support rod upright while the other uses a 3mm hex wrench to pre-tighten two M4x8 screws. After confirming the position, fully tighten the screws. Repeat the same steps for the other support rod. Next, tilt the support rods forward and place the top cover on top of the machine. One person holds the top cover while the other uses a 3mm hex wrench to pre-tighten the M4x6 screws from the outside in, securing the hinges to the machine. After all screws are in position, tighten them in the same order. Then, have one person lift the top cover to about a 60-degree angle, while the other aligns the trapezoidal plates on the support rods with the holes on the inner side of the top cover. Once aligned, use a 2mm hex wrench and two M3x4 screws to pre-tighten the lower holes of the plate, then use another two M3x4 screws to pre-tighten the upper holes. Ensure the plates are flush with the side of the top cover during installation. Repeat the same steps for the other support rod. After confirming all screws are in place, tighten the lower screws first, then the upper screws. After the top cover is installed, we can proceed to install the front door. First, remove the protective film from the front door. Have one person hold the door in position, aligning it with the front of the machine. Then, the other person uses a 3mm hex wrench to slightly loosen the four M4x8 screws connecting the hinges to the door panel. This allows for minor hinge adjustments. A quick reminder, do not loosen the screws too much, as this may cause the door panel to fall. Next, adjust the hinge position so that the holes on the hinge align with the holes on the column. Once aligned, use the 3mm hex wrench to pre-tighten one M4x8 screw into the upper hole. Repeat the same step for the lower hinge by pre-tightening one screw. After that, align the remaining holes and pre-tighten the remaining screws. Once all screws are aligned and inserted, tighten them in a diagonal sequence from outside to inside. And that's it, the front door installation is complete. After installing the Penta Shield, take out the filament spool bracket and the M4x8 screws. Use a 3mm hex wrench to mount the bracket at the back of the Penta Shield. Next, find the filament outlet next to the holder. Take the tube guide, press the outlet's protective sleeve with one hand and insert the tube guide with the other. Once that's done, insert the short PTFE tube into the back of the tube guide, then insert the long PTFE tube into the front. Make sure to gently pull the PTFE tubes to check they're secure. Finally, insert the other end of the long PTFE tube into the extruder and reattach the retaining clip. Give it another light pull to confirm everything is properly installed. That's it, the PTFE tube setup is complete. If you're installing the chroma kit, start by removing the acrylic plate on top of the Penta Shield. Use a 2mm hex wrench to loosen the M3x6 screws and take off the plate. Place the chroma kit on top of the Penta Shield, making sure it's aligned with the front edge. Then insert the four-way cable organizer through the PTFE guide hole into the machine and connect it to the extruder. Make sure the arrow marking is facing forward. After that, use a 2mm hex wrench and two M3x16 screws to secure the organizer to the extruder. And that's it, the chroma kit is installed. Now plug in the power cable and turn on the machine. On the touchscreen, tap settings, then calibration, and select resonance compensation. Once that's done, you're ready to start printing. If you want to use the fans on the Penta Shield to help with cooling during printing, make sure your firmware is updated to version 1.7.7 or later, and then update to the latest version. To turn on the fans, tap Tools, select Cooling, then tap Penta Shield switch the toggle to on, choose the filament type you're using, and the fans will automatically run during printing. That's it for the Penta Shield unboxing and installing. Hope you find this video helpful. Be sure to let us know if you have any questions in the comment section. Remember to like, subscribe, and turn on the notification for more exciting news from Phrozen. I'll see you next time. Bye.